each and every week. A little more pride, a little less fun, a little less night, a little more spark. Close your mouth and open up your heart, and baby, satisfy me. Satisfy me, baby.
A segment of this program where we're going to actually focus on education, okay? And this is going to be sort of a full true and false question time where you guys can answer some questions. If you have questions, I want you to raise your hand. Okay, so are snakes warm-blooded or reptiles? Are reptiles warm-blooded or cold-blooded?
Cold-blooded.
Okay, and can someone tell me, and this is including teachers, can somebody tell me what it means for an animal to be cold-blooded? So what happens with cold-blooded animals is if they're in a situation where the temperature is cold, like today it's kind of a cold day, they're the same temperature as the weather that's outside, if they were outside. If they need to get warmer, they need to go into an area where it's sunny and where they can get warm, okay? So they're dependent on their environment to either cool down or get warm. Okay, do snakes lay eggs or do they have live birth? How many people think the snakes lay eggs?
Or do they just come out looking like a snake? Yeah!
Okay, so...
which way?
So that's live birth. So how many people think they have live birth? Okay. Okay. So just to let you guys know that some snakes have live birth and some snakes have or lay eggs. Okay? Now there's two types of snakes that live in this area that have live birth. Can anybody tell me what types of snakes those are?
Oh baby, I'm tired of talking. Grab your coat and let's start walking.